Morning, sir.
Happy Independence
Day. Morning. Namaste.
Happy Independence Day.
Same. Same to you. Thank you. Namaste. How are you?
I am. Very happy Independence Day.
Let me extend a very warm welcome to all of you on the 67th Independence Day of India. We'll begin, as always, with a flag hoisting with Ambassador, which will be followed by the singing of the National Anthem. I would request all of you to join us in the singing of the National Anthem. May I now request Ambassador to unfurl the National Flag.
Good morning. Buenos dias a todos. And a very warm welcome to each one of you on the occasion of India's 67th Independence Day. I have the great honor to read to you the message of the Honorable President of India to the nation on the eve of India's 67th Independence Day. It is indeed a very happy and joyous occasion. But before I move on to reading the Honorable Rashtrapati Ji's speech, I would also like to express my deepest condolences and sadness on the loss of life in the tragedy that has befallen the INS Sindhu Rakshak in Mumbai yesterday. And it's very sad that there is a very strong possibility that a number of our brave men of the Indian Navy would have lost their lives with the sinking of the INS Sindhu Rakshak. So our deepest condolences to the families of those who have possibly suffered bereavement in the accident. मेरे प्यारे देशवासियों, हमारी स्वतंत्रता की 66वीं वर्षगांठ की पूर्व संध्या पर मैं आपको तथा विश्व भर में सभी भारतवासियों को हार्दिक बधाई देता हूं। My thoughts turn first towards the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, who shaped our liberation struggle and the martyrs who made supreme sacrifice for the freedom of our country and great patriots whose relentless struggle liberated our motherland from colonial rule of nearly 200 years. Gandhiji sought freedom from both foreign rule as well as the indigenous social chains that had imprisoned our society for long. He launched every Indian on a path of self-belief and hope for a better future. Gandhiji promised Swaraj, self-rule based on tolerance and self-restraint. He promised freedom from want and deprivation. For nearly 7 decades now, we have been masters of our destiny. This is then the moment to ask, are we heading in the right direction? Gandhiji's vision cannot be turned into reality if we spurn the very values that were compulsory to his cause. Sincerity of effort, honesty of purpose, and sacrifice for the larger good. Our founding fathers created the first oasis in the desert of a colonized world nourished by democracy. Democracy is much more than the right to vote every 5 years. Its essence is the aspirations of the masses. Its spirit must influence the responsibilities of the leaders and duties of the citizens every day. Democracy breeds through a vibrant parliament, an independent judiciary, a responsible media, a vigilant civil society, and a bureaucracy committed to integrity and hard work. It survives through accountability, not profligacy. And yet, we have allowed unbridled personal enrichment, self-indulgence, intolerance, discourtesy in behavior, and disrespect for authority to erode our work culture. The biggest impact of the decay in the moral fiber of our society is on the hopes and aspirations of the young and the poor. Mahatma Gandhi had advised us to avoid, and I quote, politics without principles, wealth without work, pleasure without conscience, knowledge without character, commerce without morality, science without humanity, and worship without sacrifice, unquote. We have to pay heed to his advice as we work towards building a modern democracy. The ideals of patriotism, compassion, tolerance, self-restraint, honesty, discipline, and respect for women have to be converted into a living force. Fellow citizens, institutions are a mirror of national character. Today, we see widespread cynicism and disillusionment with the governance and functioning of institutions in our country. Our legislatures look more like combat arenas rather than fora that legislate. Corruption has become a major challenge. The precious resources of the nation are being wasted through indolence and indifference. It is sapping the dynamism of our society. We need to correct this regression. Fellow citizens, there is a direct relationship between a successful democracy and a successful economy. For we are a people-driven nation. People serve their interests best when they participate in decision-making at the level of panchayat and other forms of local government. We have to rapidly empower the local bodies with functions, functionaries, and finances to improve their performance. Faster growth has given us the resources, but larger outlays have not translated into better outcomes. Without inclusive governance, we cannot achieve inclusive growth. The last decade has seen India emerge as one of the fastest growing nations in the world. During this period, our economy grew annually at an average rate of 7.9%. We are today self-sufficient in food grains production. We are the largest exporter of rice, and second largest exporter of wheat in the world. The record production of 18.45 million tons of pulses this year augurs well for our march towards self-sufficiency in pulses. This was unthinkable just a few years ago. This momentum has to be sustained. In a globalized world with increasing economic complexities, we have to learn to cope better with adversities, both external and domestic. Reforms that have enabled us to come this far have to be pursued at all levels of governance. Favorable demographic changes over the next two decades can pay us handsome dividends. It requires industrial transformation and rapid creation of employment opportunities. It also requires an orderly urbanization process. Several initiatives taken by the government in the recent past, including the new manufacturing policy, the renewal of urban infrastructure, and the ambitious skill training program, will need close monitoring in the coming years. Fellow citizens, in our race for development, we must be careful not to disturb the balance between man and nature. The consequences of such imbalance can be disastrous. My heartfelt condolences to the many who lost their lives and innumerable who suffered in Uttarakhand, and my salutations to those brave personnel of our security and armed forces, government and NGOs who did so much to alleviate suffering. This tragedy owes as much to the avarice of human nature as to the rage of Mother Nature. This was nature's wake-up call, and it is time to wake up. There will be a general election in our country before I have the privilege of addressing you again on the eve of the next Independence Day. This great festival of democracy is an opportunity for us to elect a stable government which will ensure security and economic development. Every election must become a crucial milestone in our nation's journey towards greater social harmony, peace, and prosperity. Let me conclude by quoting from the great classic Bhagavad Gita, where the teacher propounds his views and then says, and I quote, "Yatha ichchasi tatha kuru." Even as you choose, so you do. I do not wish to impose my views on you. I have presented to you what I think is right. Now it is for your conscience, for your judgment, for your mind to decide what is right." Unquote. आपके निर्णयों पर ही हमारे लोकतंत्र का भविष्य निर्भर है. जय हिंद.
जय हिंद.
I also wish to take this opportunity once again to welcome each one of you, members of the Indian community in Mexico, distinguished members of Mexican society from all walks of life, friends of India, members of the media, one and all. I wish to thank you for your attendance this morning, and I take this opportunity to wish you success, good health and prosperity through all times to come. I also want to emphasize the point that we in the Indian Embassy in Mexico are working hard at all times to promote bilateral relations between these two most friendly nations, India and Mexico. Our bilateral ties have grown by leaps and bounds in recent years, especially in the field of trade, commerce and economic engagement. Our leaders have a good understanding and frequent exchange of views and visits. And all this lends fresh impetus to the future growth in our bilateral relations. Both India and Mexico are large countries, populous countries with ancient civilizations and rich cultural heritage. We have much in common. We value unity in diversity. We are pluralistic. And we are both working hard to build the edifices of modern institutions on the bedrock and foundation of our ancient cultures. Both India and Mexico have a very bright future as emerging economies. We have much to look forward to in terms of economic development and in terms of social progress. So let us today rededicate ourselves and recommit ourselves to the task of building our respective nations and also to the task of forging even closer relations, mutually beneficial relations and understanding between our two great countries. Thank you very much. Muchísimas gracias a todos.
और कभी नन्ही सी बेटी बन के या मिटाने से नहीं मिटते, डराने से नहीं डरते, वतन के नाम पे
for you, some soft drinks, tea and coffee or breakfast, all of you could have some before you leave. Thank you so much.